previously on From Date to Mate.
My ex-boyfriend is doing a show where he's being followed around by a camera crew too. It's like a Jewish dating show he's doing or something.
I think that might be the same show.
So I'll call you.
Better call me.
I promise.
So do you ever ditch the cameras?
I don't know. I haven't tried yet.
Should we try now? Ooh, shut the door. Are you gonna get in trouble?
I don't know. I've never done this before. Sorry, I didn't know what to do.
What do you mean you didn't know what to do?
Well, we had a couple of drinks. Well, more than a couple of drinks, and I'm sorry. It just got, you know, a little out of hand, and I didn't know how to deal with the situation. I didn't know how to handle it.
What didn't you know how to handle? We've gone over this. We had meetings specifically about this issue before.
Right, but it was her apartment. You know,
right.
I didn't have any control whether or not you guys could come in or out, you know? What, would you rather I not go in? I mean, are you going to block me like that?
Of course not. All you had to do was close the bedroom door. That's all you have to do. And it's done. You know, we're not okay. Trying to film you have sex. We don't want to do Paris Hilton. We don't want to do Kim Kardashian. We're not trying to do that here.
I didn't see the difference between closing a bedroom door and closing a door to the apartment building.
So what happened?
I mean, you didn't miss anything. It's not like I didn't sleep with her.
Right, you didn't.
No. I didn't.
Really?
We made out a little bit, but that was it.
See, I don't even know if you're lying right now.
Why would I lie about not sleeping
with
someone?
Why would you lie about not sleeping with someone? I don't know why you wouldn't. People lie about these things, okay?
Sorry, it won't happen again. I just...
Thank you. Thank you. That's all. I have every right to get bent out of shape, okay? My cast is being crazy people right now.
Why am I a crazy person?
Okay,
I have other issues that I'm dealing with, too. It's not all you. I'm sorry that I'm freaking out a little bit. I have the situation with Sarah that I have to deal with right now, actually, and... I need my coffee, and
Sorry, it won't happen again.
Okay,
I promise.
Thank you, Justin. I'm sorry. We'll continue. Thank you. Guys, please sit up.
So, apparently the producers were a little pissed that I ditched the cameras last night. And I think Sarah's gonna get kicked off the show.
Right, well, they're telling me that you hooked up with both of them.
So then this is all true?
Yeah.
I left you in charge of this whole thing. You put together this cast. It's all on you.
I am so sorry. No, I am so sorry. I had no idea she was going to be like this.
And
of course.
The whole time you're telling me how sweet and innocent Sarah was.
I know. It was. I take complete blame for this. I mean, she's the last person I would imagine would sleep with a crew member, let alone two crew members.
God. You have to check this out. Look at this girl right here. Her name is Brett Cohen. She is another cast member on the show, which you guys probably already knew. But anyways, she just met Paige the other day. She's a real estate agent, and she's helping her show her apartments. Oh my God. That is so weird. This is seriously unreal. Such a small world sometimes.
What are you guys shooting?
It's a reality dating show called From Date to Mate.
Right on. So you've got a hot date going on?
No, not really. Not at the moment.
Well, that's a shame.
Yeah.
Hey, that's a really cute dog. What kind of dog is this? A baby lab?
No, he's a puggle.
Puggle, that's right. These dogs are getting really popular right now.
Yeah.
Well, yours isn't he just the cutest little guy?
Thank you.
What's his name?
Sly.
Sly, that is a dope name.
Yeah.
What's his mommy's name?
Oh, God. Sophia.
You sure?
Yeah, I just had to think about it for a second.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
Sly, Sophia. It was really nice to meet you. Good luck with all this.
Thanks. So, did you mean me, Sophia?
What?
You didn't. Did you mean to call me Sophia?
Of course.
I don't know why. My name is Brett. I thought that you were asking Sly's dog mommy's name.
Right.
I feel
exactly.
Kind of
yeah. Well, Brett, it was nice meeting you. I think I'm starting to realize why you don't have any dates lined up, you know?
No,
just kidding. Listen, but since we've gone through all this, I think I'm going to have to ask you for your number so I can take you out on a date sometime.
You're going to have to ask me for my number?
That's right.
Well, isn't the have to get a date?
Really? Cool.
Interesting. Kind of cute. I mean, way too early to nitpick, but I don't know about him saying the word dope. Like, Sly had a dope name. I just think about all the yo boys back in high school or something.
So basically that's what happened. You know, I don't want to get too much into detail. I don't really know the details, but basically she was having relations with crew members, and so we can't keep her on the show.
You're serious?
I'm sorry, yeah.
I'm absolutely shocked.
As are we. We're completely shocked, and I feel personally responsible, and I'm very sorry to you. I know you had sort of a thing going. I don't know how much you felt for her.
Of course this had happened. You know, I like someone, and something has to happen to screw it up.
Honestly, I feel terrible, and I've been working on this for you. I really want to find someone for you, and I think I've found someone that you're really gonna like. She's really cute.
Hi, my name is Zoe. I'm 27 years old. I guess you could say that I'm on the verge of getting over a breakup. I don't know, it's kind of why I joined the whole online dating community. I guess the best way to get over someone is to meet someone new, right? I'm about to go out with Daniel. He looks pretty cute, so we'll see what happens.
In your message you say you were going to bed, but I'm not
Hello?
Done with night.
Hey, it's me.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
What's up?
Just have something really funny to tell you.
Oh, yeah? Wait, let me guess. You met someone on my show named Brett.
Yeah, how did you find out?
She friended me on Facebook.
Oh my God, well, how insane is that?
I know, right? Almost like it's a sign, you know.
What? That we should be together?
Well, no, I wasn't going to say that exactly, but, you know, just that we should stay connected. I mean, I think it can be hard at times. I mean, you're still an extremely important person to me, you know, in my life, and I'd be willing to keep whatever friendship we have, you know, that both of us can handle.
Well, I feel the same way.
Well, good. We can still be friends then. Mm-hmm. I'll see you in a couple hours. All right. Bye. Well, looks like I'm getting lunch with Paige today.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good. It's good to see you.
Yes. Good to see me when I'm not holding a set of speakers over my head outside your building.
It was good to see you then, too. You know, you really caught me off guard.
Well, I wasn't expecting you to have company, so.
Yeah, I know. No, that really wasn't.
You know, we don't need to talk about this, though. It's not going to get us anywhere, you know?
How crazy is that about Brett?
Oh, my God, I know. Is she really helping you, or is this some sort of setup with show?
No, she's really helping me find an apartment. We're actually supposed to meet later this week and go look at a couple more, so.
That's crazy.
Yeah. No one really ever wins in heartbreak. Whoa.
my parents liked you. They just had some concern, but I'm sure your parents did also.
My parents wanted me to be happy.
Yeah, but they weren't exactly thrilled that I'm not Jewish.
Well, their only concern was how we were going to raise our children. Why? What did your parents say to you?
Well, they didn't want me to convert if we got married. And they, I think more of it was they didn't want me to feel pressured by you to convert.
Pressured by me? You thought I was going to pressure you to convert?
No, I didn't think that.
But your parents did. I mean, did this have anything to do with why you didn't want to move in together?
No, it didn't. Not at all. Just I wasn't ready to move in with you then. And I know it made sense because both of our leases were up, but I didn't want to move in together out of convenience.
Convenience.
Okay, not convenience, but look, Justin, we're going to try to have a friendship. We can't keep doing
this. No, you're right. You're right. I can't believe your parents didn't like me.
Drop it. Well, it was really good to see you.
Yeah, it's good to see you too.
So, I guess I probably will see you at Kyle's party?
Yeah, I guess I'll go.
Okay. So I guess I'll see you there.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Can I get you a drink?
Sure.
What do you have?
I'll have a Stella.
Stella it is? She's really cute. Totally my type. So what do you do?
I'm an event planner. I actually work with a number of Jewish organizations.
Oh, wow. That sounds really cool.
I actually love my job.
Yeah?
Yeah. So what are your parents like?
Oh, God. Mom is mom. You know, she calls me at least 3 times a week, of course.
Three times a week? That's nothing.
How is the online dating world treating you? The big question.
It's taking a little getting used to.
Yeah.
I don't know. You're actually only my second date, but my first one was not the greatest experience.
Yeah. Well, yeah, you know what? I can empathize with you. My first date could have been a little bit better. My second date went really well. Until I found out that she was a little overzealous with the crew.
Oh my God, it's just like that girl in The Bachelor.
I know.
So, it's a Jewish dating show.
Yes, it focuses on 4 Jewish singles.
And is it a requisite that the guys you go on dates with be Jewish?
No, but we're encouraged to go out on dates with people through JMatch. So.
Did you know I was Jewish?
Yeah, I had a feeling.
Do you have a Jewish vibe, do I?
No, I don't know, you don't necessarily look Jewish. I hate when people say that, but I think I have good Judar.
Judar? That is good. I like that.
Judar.
You have really good Judar.
I have excellent Judar.
Really? What's your percent? 100%?
100%.
That's awesome. That's a really special
power.
Probably
not 100%. I mean, you can't always. Obviously, you can't always tell.
You gotta tell me, what's it like having all these cameras around you all the time?
I mean, it's bizarre. You know, how do you feel being taped?
Yeah, it's a little unsettling to say the least. And, you know, I think most first dates are nerve-wracking just as they are. And the fact that we're going to potentially be seen and analyzed by a large amount of people, it can make anyone that much more self-conscious. Like, I'm wondering how my hair is looking right now.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm freaked out. I hope it looks good. Not just to you.
It looks good.
Is it good?
Yeah, it looks good. I like it.
It's good.
You have good hair. You're welcome. I just feel like I think about all these people that are watching me. I mean, people that I know, people that I don't know. And I mean, I don't know which is worse, like strangers analyzing me or the people that I know.
Do you have a problem with people analyzing you?
Well, I mean, who doesn't though? You know? I mean, I wouldn't say I have a problem. But I guess it makes me just like a little bit uncomfortable.
So anyway, what do you do for a living?
I'm a psychiatrist.
Joker.
I swear to God.
So, can I get you a drink? Would you like a beer?
Don't ask me why I'm showing you my iPhone apps.
This one is completely useless.
Uh-huh.
It was kind of fun.
Because the other one was so useful. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, I guess. It's still fun.
Okay. Uh-huh. What else you got?
All right. I'm really showing off my geekdom though with this,
all right.
Obviously.
No, it's okay. I totally have iPhone envy. Oh, God.
Yeah, yeah. That's pretty much it. The rest of them actually do things that are important, so that's about it. Yeah.
So, are you hungry at all? Cause
yeah.
There's just a table over there, and so I was just thinking.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
I mean, Up in the Air was good, but it wasn't anything exceptional, you know?
Yeah, no, I completely agree.
So what was your favorite, like, of the year?
Well, it was a pretty weak year for movies, but Inglourious Basterds definitely topped my list out, absolutely.
I can somewhat agree with you on that. I mean, favorite of the year, probably not, but it was good.
How could you not be in love with the premise that as a group of Jews seeking revenge on the Nazis?
I don't know, it was just, it was something about the end, about rewriting history, you know? Just, I couldn't take it seriously, just tainted the whole movie for me, I don't know.
Did you pick up on Quentin's pomposity with the last line? This just might be my masterpiece.
I'm sorry. Did you just use pomposity in a sentence?
I believe I did.
Speaking of pompous directors, you a fan of Avatar?
Believe it or not, I still haven't seen it.
No way. I haven't seen it either.
Really?
Yeah.
We must be like the only two people in America who still haven't seen it.
I know, seriously. We should go.
I'd totally be into that.
Like, tonight.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah?
I would totally go, yeah.
You want to?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Done.
I'm actually kind of liking him. I don't know if it's the wine talking or what, but I don't know, I think we're clicking. I haven't had this much fun with a guy in a while. And so, date continues.
I think it's kind of funny that I'm on a reality TV show. I mean, I hate reality television. No, I don't hate it. I just feel like, well, there are some shows that are okay, but most, have you seen Jersey Shore?
I watched one episode, and I thought my brain was just frying, like I was just losing neurons by every second I was watching. It's just like, why don't we just watch Jerry Springer? Just as bad.
Totally is. Oh God, is this show gonna turn into something like that? Like, could they spin that?
We don't have to let it be. I mean, we can just turn it all academic and let's have like a intellectual conversation. You know what? Let's pretend we're like Wolf Blitzer and CNN. You could be Sanjay Gupta. We could talk about the situation in Afghanistan or Haiti or, you know, the two-state solution debate in Israel, you know, keep it highbrow.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Or we can just put everybody to sleep right now. Plus, political conversations on a first date.
Okay.
Kind of risky. Kind of taboo.
That's true. I'm not one of those people that gets all bent out of shape if people don't agree with my personal political opinions. I mean, people are entitled to their political opinions, no matter how misinformed I think they might be.
I agree. I mean, I don't really get too heated either. But I think that everybody else thinks that their, you know, opinion is correct and the other person is on the misinformed side. Like, you know, the shows that they watch and the shows that they listen to and, you know, blogs.
You don't know.
Newspapers. Oh yeah, and that they're the ones that are brainwashed, and
the shows that I watch and the shows that I listen to and the things that I read are really, you know, portraying the accurate and unbiased side.
Well, I'm sure they are. You're a smart girl. I'm sure you read what's right. No, I hear you. But you're a liberal. I take it, right?
Conversation best saved for another time.
Really?
Unobtainium? Are you kidding me?
Is that what they call it?
Yes!
That's, you know, that's really silly, but I mean, overall, it was pretty friggin' awesome.
What? What? It was childish.
Well, I guess I'm a child at heart because I liked it.
Wow. First chink in the armor. Come on. I don't
know. So, you want to get a drink somewhere? Go to my place if you want. It's right around... Actually, that's a little forward, isn't it?
No, yeah, I do.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm, like, a couple blocks away.
Okay.
Okay. All right, cool. It's like a few blocks this way. Come on.
This was really fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm really glad that you talked to me the other day.
Me too. Are you kidding me? I'm like ecstatic. And you are a super cool chick and you're really beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
I'll give you a call this weekend.
Okay.
Maybe we can get dinner next time.
That sounds good.
Sounds good?
Yeah.
Cool. Thank you. All right. So sleep tight.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye.
The way that it came off, I didn't. We're not gonna have sex. I mean, not that I have any rules against sex, because I don't. It's just that I just meant for privacy is all that I.
Yeah. No. I got you. Let's go inside. It's funny because Nora was just telling me about the bedroom door rule.
That's weird. She mentioned the same thing to me.
Really.
Off.
Yeah, that'd probably be a good idea. Get that. Oh, here, let me get yours for you.
So this is Allison. Pretty attractive, right?
To me when you smile.
please to send a complimentary DVD of this program to anyone who can send a tax-deductible contribution of $18 or more to the nonprofit organization Jewish Education in Media to help support our programming. Tax-deductible checks may be made out to JEM and mailed to JEM, Post Office Box 180, Riverdale Station, Bronx, New York, 10471. Please indicate the program for which you would like a DVD, and we thank you for your kind support.